hungry?
I'm starving.
Hello.
We're very lucky.
Yeah, you are. But you deserve it. You're both such lovely people.
Mum, Dad, this is Katie.
Hello.
This is Tom and Gerri.
Hello.
Tom and Gerri, that's brilliant.
This is for you, Tom.
Yeah, Buenos Aires.
Yeah, because I thought that. Well, you went there, didn't you? The two of you, Argentina.
No, I didn't, no.
Didn't you?
Eat, drink, be merry.
It's lovely having your dinner cooked for you. You don't really bother when you're by yourself, do you? I don't, anyway.
He was a good-looking man when he was young.
Was he?
Hmm. Life's not always kind, is it?
Great. So, Jim and Lesley, both of you are veteran actors on theater and film and TV, and you're longtime collaborators with Mike Lee on several projects. Now, what was it like working on this film another year on the set with Mike?
It was great. I mean, I think that he's just got, we've both known him for 30 years and been working with him for that long. But I think it was great because I think this film is, I think it's him at his peak, really. It's a very good bit of mature, grown-up filmmaking.
I mean, it's in a way, it's classic Mike Lee, where you don't know what you're going to be playing, you don't know what it's going to be about, you agree to sign on for a long period of time, most of last year, and you don't know where you're going, so, and you build up the characters individually with him, one-to-one, and then you improvise and you get a very tight script in the end. But his way of working hasn't changed over 30 years. The basic rules are absolutely the same as they were when I first worked with him a long time ago.
He also, he wrote this as well, and it's sort of...
No, he doesn't write it. We work with him and we create the characters and create the script out of improvisations,
It says written by Mike Lee because that's what.
But it's a collaboration of the performances with your experiences. I want to ask about the character of Mary, who is, I think, did a phenomenal job at capturing the complexity of who she is, and it seems like she has lived a life where she's wanted so much and she hasn't achieved it. How would you?
Well, I think what she wants is quite simple. She just wants what all of us want, probably, which is a partner in life to share things with and, make enrich your life, which is what she sees Gerri and Tom having. And she just hasn't had any of that. You know, I mean, we created a woman who'd had a disastrous childhood and was abandoned and had miserable relationships, bad relationships, abusive relationships. So if you put all that into the melting pot, you're going to end up with a woman of Mary's age who, in some way, has a desperation about her. Her needs are simple, but just love.
Almost like universal love. Needs that we all have.
Exactly.
That was quick, Tom. Didn't you get the manure?
Compost.
Oh, here's Joe.
Hi, Mary.
Hello, Joe. What a surprise.
You're all right?
I'm great. How are you? Oh, continental. It's all sweaty.
I've been riding all morning.
Have you? I like your hat.
Uh-huh.
Oh, that's right. Never forget to kiss your mum.
I never do.
No, you're a good boy, aren't you?
Yeah.
I remember when you were this big, you were a naughty boy.
I still am from time to time.
Oh, really?
I like your coat.
Oh, thank you. I think I'm a bit overdressed for a Sunday morning. What do you think?
Is that what you wore in bed?
Slept in your bed, actually. Is that all right?
As long as you clean the sheets.
Oh, I didn't, actually. Is that a problem?
We'll have to wait and see, won't we?
All right. Oh, sorry, Tom. I'm in your way. All these strong men. Look at his muscles.
That's why we had him.
All right, well, I'm off then.
No one to lift to the station?
Oh, no, it's all right.
You sure?
Yeah, I'll be fine. I could do with a walk.
Yeah.
Sorry about, you know.
It's okay.
Well, it's good to see you.
Oh, thank you, Tom.
Are you all right?
Yeah, you know. Had a bit of a wild night, Joe. Well, I'd best be off.
It seems like Tom and Gerri were very empathetic with her. And all of their friends, they almost host the, you know, all their friends with their issues. How was that, how would you speak to that in terms of the role of sort of being a nurturer
I mean, it all comes through the development of the characters and the relationship over the, you know, the 5 months of all that before we start filming. And that's who the characters are by that time. He works with in the soil and the rocks, and she works as a therapist, and that's sort of who they are. And their hobby is the garden and working in the garden, and that's very sort of second nature to them, really, to be. And they know they're lucky. They know they've got the security of each other's love and their family and their professional lives. So, in a way, it's second nature for them to be, to a degree, open to their less fortunate friends.
Briefly, let's talk about the relationship with Joe, Tom and Gerri's son, and Mary. What was happening with that? And what do you think she was?
Well, you know, he's a nice-looking young guy, and that's what appeals to her. She doesn't really want to go for Ken, who is perhaps more suitable, but she sees Ken as somebody she sees him as a bit of a slob, he doesn't look after himself. And he certainly doesn't reflect her image of herself, which is you know, youthful, vibrant. You know, she's in denial, obviously. But you know, there's a young guy there, Joe, and she's known him all his life. But now he's a man, and she's going to flirt. She flirts with him. It's inappropriate. I'm not saying that it's the way she should have behaved. I mean, it's inappropriate because it's Gerri and Tom's son. It's not inappropriate because she's older and he's younger. It's inappropriate because it's the wrong guy to flirt with, really.
Well, thank you. I think the film is excellent. It's definitely relatable to, I think, all, you know, generations, even though the characters are a certain age. So
yeah,
thank you. It's excellent.
Thank you.
Cheers.